morning, students. Well, the topic of the day is electrostatics of a conductor. Electrostatics of a conductor. A conductor. Conductor in the sense metal, either metal slabs. Conductor. Right. How they behave? What is the electrostatic nature of conductors? Right. We discuss it in point wise. The first point is, whenever conductors are placed in electric field or charge is given to a conductor, the net electric field inside the conductor is zero. Already in each and every topic we discussed earlier, when we come across conductors, we discuss this point. The net electric field inside a conductor is zero, right? This is the first point. Net electric field inside a conductor, inside a conductor is zero. Why, sir? There are two cases. Let this one. This So this is the positive plate and this is the negative plate. A uniform electric field is setting up between these two. So that electric field, let us say E naught. Uniform electric field acting between these plates. Now what I am doing, I am placing a metal slab. This is a metal slab. Metal slab in a sense, conducting slab. In the electric field. See, in what direction electric field is acting? We know electric field acts from positive to negative. So this is the applied electric field you have. This is the applied electric field. In what direction it is? This time. What is the electric field inside of this metal slab, metal conductor? See, this is solid metal slab. A metal slab. I place it in an electric field. So what happens? We know inside a metal, free electron availability is present. So the electrons which are free in outermost orbit, they come out and they are in a position to move in the lattice, which contribute in conduction. That is why it is called as conductor. Whenever I place this metal slab in the electric field, what happened to those electrons? immediately whatever the electrons present inside, see, if there is an electron, let one electron inside, these electrons experience a force opposite to the direction of the field. Electrons are attracted by the positive plate. So inside the metal slab, electrons, they experience a force towards the positive plate. So almost all the electrons, they move towards the positive plate. Electrons are moving and they come nearing, almost all the electrons are coming nearer to this positive plate. Means what? Total negative charges accumulating on this side. So as a result, a negative charge accumulates on the side. A negative charge accumulates because all the negative electrons are relatively moving this side. Once total negative charge, that means the group of electrons are moving this side, relatively this side becomes positive. So when as the electrons are moving, this side becomes negative, so this side relatively becomes positive. So this is the thing happens inside a metal plate whenever it is kept in an electric field. Well, so these charges, these negative charges, these positive charges develop on the surfaces in the metal plate. So they are induced charges. These charges are called induced charges. So technically, charges are induced. Induced charges. See here, this is negative and this is positive. So due to this positive and negative charge, inside this metal slab, an electric field is set up. So in what direction? We know always electric field is from positive to negative. So a electric field is set up, I am taking it as EI in this direction. Applied electric field is in this direction. In the metal slab, induced electric field is in this direction, right? This EI, you call it as induced electric field. Induced electric field. Now there are two electric fields. What are they? Applied electric field. This is E naught. Induced electric field. Induced electric field. See, these electrons start moving. Up to what extent they can move? Till they reach an equilibrium position. Equilibrium position means what? That equilibrium state is they stop moving and total negative charge accumulates here, total positive charge accumulates here, and there is no further movement. That position is called equilibrium position. At that position, at equilibrium, what happens? This field becomes equal to this field. The net force acting on the electrons becomes zero. Due to this field, force due to external charge E naught, let charge is Q, E naught Q, or on a single electron, E naught E. Force due to induced field. E E on each electron, right? At equilibrium position is the position where the net force is zero. So this F naught is equal to F induced. That means E naught E is equal to E E E. See, due to this, electron moves in this direction. Due to this, electron moves in this direction, because always electron moves opposite to the direction of the field. Electric field is in this direction, electrons moves opposite. Only this electric field is acting in this direction. Because of the movement of electron, another electric field is set up inside. See the direction from here to here. So it tries to take the electron in this direction, right? That means here, if you see, F naught direction is like this. Sorry, in this way. Due to this, in this, are they not opposite? Opposite. E naught is equal to E. E induced. E induced. So inside now there are two electric fields. One is applied electric field. Another one is induced electric field due to movement of the electrons. Right? How those two fields are at equilibrium? They are equal. So what is the net electric field? E net. Difference of E naught and EI. When these two are equal, this is zero. So E net is equal to zero. This is the reason E net is zero. So what is this condition? Conductor placed in electric field. Conductor placed in electric field. In the theory bits, there is a possibility of getting. Whenever a conductor is placed in electric field, what is the net electric field inside? Zero. Right? Come on, note up. Now we go to case 2. Case 2 is charge is given to a conductor. When charge is given to a conductor, charge is the conductor itself charged. What is the electric field inside? There conductor is placed in electric field. Now what I am telling you, see here, this is a conductor of any shape. Conductor of any shape. It is a conductor, like a metal. Solid one. Solid. A conducting. Let Q charge is given to that. Q amount of charge is given to that. Some charge is given to this conductor. What happens? See, in case of a conductor, when charge is given to that, this is all positive charge. First, it spread throughout the conductor. It spread throughout the conductor. Whenever charge is given, first, this charge just spread throughout the conductor, but like charges ripple, right? Whenever charges are given to S1 coulomb, 2 coulomb, 3 coulomb, like, giving a charge is nothing but what? Either taking electron or giving electron. Conductor, name itself tells you, it conducts. There is a possibility for the electrons to move. Whenever electrons to move or the charges to move, they repel each other because we are giving only same positive charge or negative charge. Whatever the charge is given, all those like charges, they repel. First they go into the conductor, but inside the conductor, charges have a chance to move. So as all the charges which we are giving is like charges, they repel. See, let us think, whatever the charge you are given is like this. Initially, this positive charge is repelled. This positive charge is repelled by this positive charge. They repel. So where it can go? It can go onto the surface maximum. This positive charge is repelled by this positive charge. It can go here. This positive charge can be repelled by this. It goes here. This can be repelled. It can go. This positive charge, it can go like this. This positive charge repelled by this. Here. This positive charge by this. Here. This one. Like, due to repulsion, because all are like charges, only one type of charge that we are giving, charge to a conductor. They repel. Up to what extent they can go? The limit is what? Onto the surface of the body. So maximum they repel till they come onto the surface. Clear? Now, what about discharge? Discharge is repelled by this. So it has up to what maximum extent? Come onto the surface. So they come on to the surface. Discharge, it comes onto the surface. Discharge, it comes onto the surface. Discharge, 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 discharge. Now what happened? Whatever the charge is given to a conductor, first it goes inside. But due to their mutual repulsion, they repel with each other. Up to what? Because in the conductor, those charges are free to move. So once repulsive force acts, they move. So in what direction they move? Up to what extent they move? They can move on to the surface of the conductor. This is the limit. So all the charges due to repulsion, they move away from each other and they come onto the surface and they reside onto the surface. So in the previous sections, previous topics we discussed, wherever conductor word comes, whether it is conducting sphere or conducting cylinder or conducting plate, what we said, whenever charge is given to a conducting sphere, it resides on the surface. Cylinder, conducting cylinder, resides on the surface. Conducting plate resides on the surface. So it is a big question, why? This is the reason. First it goes inside, but due to repulsion, as they have a tendency to move, they are free to move, they move up to their limit. That limit is surface. So they come onto the surface and they accumulate on the surface. Here one more important point. If it is a non-conductor, non-conducting, whatever charge is given, that charge resides throughout the volume, we said. Why, sir? Now you can simply answer. Inside a non-conductor, charges are not free. They cannot move. So there is no force of attraction or repulsion between them. Right? So they stay there itself. There are no availability of free electrons. So they stay there itself. That is the reason. Right? One is one of the most important points here. So whatever the charge is given to you, given to this conductor, it resides on the surface. Clear? Well, once the total charge goes onto the surface, what is Q in? Inside, what is the charge? If you are asked, Q in is zero. Whenever inside there is no charge, according to the Gauss law, if there is no Q enclosed, What is the field inside? Field inside is zero. In case of spheres and cylinders, we proved it already. And if there is no field, is there any flux inside? Flux is zero. This is the second case. This is first case. Metal slab is kept in a field. Net field becomes zero because of the opposite induced field. When even charge is given to a conductor, due to repulsion between like charges, all the charges accumulate on the surface. Inside, no charge resides. So Q in is zero. According to the Gauss law, when there is no induced charge inside, field is zero. If field is zero, flux is zero. Right? This is second case. Okay, come on, note down. Inside conductor Q in zero, E in zero, pi in zero. This is second case. Come on, note down. Well, next one. See here, charge is given to a conductor, then it is clear to us, inside there is no charge, inside there is no field, inside there is no flux. Clear? Well, so whenever inside there is no flux, what is the field outside? Third point. Outside the conductor, outside the charged conductor, outside the charged conductor, electric field for the same charged conductor. This is the charged conductor. See, I am taking irregular shape. Any shape you can take, whether it is sphere, cylinder, plate, or any irregular shape. Any shape you can, if this is the conductor and charge is given to this, that Q charge is given, already diagram is there. What happens? That charge resides on the surface. How it resides? It uniformly distributes on the surface. It uniformly distributes on the surface. There is a word. Uniformly distributes on the surface. There is a uniform distribution. Uniform distribution means for any unit area, if you take, charge is same. Means what? Charge density. Charge density. Sigma. Q by surface area A is constant. Uniform charge density it gets, right? It distributes uniformly in the sense charge density is uniform. One thing. Second, what is the electric field? outside the charged conductor. What is electric field? Electric field E. Already we discussed sigma by epsilon naught. Sigma by, see, if you take a point here, here, what is the electric field? Electric field where? Outside the conductor. Electric field outside E equal to sigma by epsilon naught at this point, or at this point, or at this point, at this point, at this point, at this point, wherever, just outside of the conductor or outside the conductor, electric field is sigma by epsilon naught. Remember, irrespective of the shape of the conductor, again and again I'm telling you, irrespective of the shape, whether this shape is a sphere, whether this shape is a cylinder or a plate, any shape outside of that is equal to sigma by epsilon naught outside, where sigma is charge density, right? This is one of the important point. For any conductor charged with Q, outside and charge density sigma, outside the conductor E equal to sigma by epsilon naught. Well, generally this charge, and it is strongly electrified, electric field strength is strong, we can use this formula. Or this conductor is very big, you can use that formula, right? One more. Okay, there is an electric field. For electric field, there must be a direction. So what is the direction of the electric field? Next point. What is the direction of the electric field? For any charged conductor, the direction of the electric field always normal to the surface at that point. If I draw the electric lines of force here, at any point, if you are asked to draw the electric lines of force, how those electric lines of force are? They are normal to the surface. See, next point is what? Electric lines of force are electric field direction normal to the surface at any point, right? Normal to the surface. See here, if I take a unit area, normal to this, here normal to this, here normal to this, here normal, like normal to this at any point, right? Tangential to the surface, no component of electric field. Whatever electric field, it is in this direction for a charged conductor. If I ask a question, tangential to this surface, here at this point, if I draw the tangent, tangent comes like this. Tangential to the surface, what is the component? E tangential, zero, because total E is in this direction only. Tangential component of electric field to the surface is zero. You can add that point also. Tangential component of electric field, zero. There is no component along the direction of the electric direction of the tangent to the surface, right? Always it is normal, normal. Okay, next. Next point. Well, next one. So one of the most important thing, important point, regularly we see the questions and the entrance. Cavity in a conductor. Cavity in a conductor. See, this is a conductor. This is a conductor, right? Of any shape. Of any shape. This is solid one. Conducting slab or conducting sphere or conducting one of any shape, the metal one. In this, a cavity is created. Cavity means some part is removed. An empty space is created. Let this is the cavity. Empty space inside. Regarding this, some important points. Whenever I give the charge to this conductor, whenever I give the charge to this conductor which has cavity, here is the cavity. Now I give the charge to this. What happens? Whenever charge is given to a conductor which is having this cavity, we know that charge distributes uniformly on the surface. But there is a small doubt. There is, this is also a free one also. Inner side of the cavity, we call it as this surface. Inner surface, inner side of the cavity, this one. Here there is no charge. If charge is given to a conductor, in this case, inner on inner walls of cavity. On inner walls of the cavity, this is inner wall of the cavity, inner surface of the cavity, charge is zero. Whatever the charge you give, it accumulate on the surface only. On the inner wall, there is no cavity, there is no charge. Here on the inner wall, there is no charge. One thing, right? Charge is given to a conductor having cavity. On inner walls of cavity, charge is zero. But where is the charge? Charge accumulates on the surface only. Charge distributes on surface only, on inner walls of the cavity, no charge, right? Okay. Next. This is a conductor. Same. Solid. One. With cavity. With cavity. Now, charge is placed inside the cavity, at the center of the cavity. Charge is placed at center of cavity. One of the important point, simple point, but very important point. Charge is placed at the center of the cavity. What happens? Come on. What happens here? Charge is placed at the center of the cavity. Here is the charge now. Here is the charge. Plus Q is placed at the center of the cavity. What happens to the charge on inner walls? What happens to the charge on outer wall? Outer surface of the conductor. First point. On inner walls, charge induces. Charge induces. See, on the inner wall, some charge comes. That charge is minus Q. Exactly same of this magnitude, but opposite. On the inner walls, a charge induces. How much is this charge? This charge is minus Q. One of the very important on the outer surface, on the outer surface, charge comes. How much? Plus Q. Whenever a charge, when a charge plus Q is placed at center of cavity, on inner walls charge induces. That charge is minus Q. On outer surface, charge comes as plus Q, right? This charge comes on outer surface. Come on, write down. You may get it out. Why, sir? There is an explanation. First, write down. So this empty space, cavity, here is the cavity, this is cavity. So in tomorrow class, I'll explain why it is so, why is negative charge and why is positive charge. In the coming chapters, whenever you are dealing problems with conductors, with cavity, this is very important thing, right? Why it is so and what happens to electric lines of force and when this charge is moved inside. What happens to the charge on the surface? Charge here is there any change occurs. In tomorrow class, we discuss. Okay.